Hey, what is going on, everybody? This is Jonathan Ferrell, and today I want to show you guys how to set up your phone number in GoHighLevel. Now, this is the 2025 version. There have been some recent changes inside of GoHighLevel, and that impacts how the phone numbers get set up. I want to show you guys how to enable like missed call text back and all the SMS compliance features within the phone number setting. So once you're navigating into your GoHighLevel account and you're ready to purchase your phone number, you go ahead and navigate to settings, and we're going to navigate to phone numbers right here. Okay. Now, I've already purchased a phone number in this account. This phone number is already A2P verified. So I'm going to show you how to get a brand new phone number. First, on this top right hand side, you would select the add number section and then click add phone number right here. Now, this is going to give you a whole bunch of different local numbers. In this case, what we need to do is if we want to find a specific zip code or area code, like I did right here, 321, this gentleman's in Florida, we would navigate to the filter button and we would go ahead and select the area code that we are looking to purchase in. We're going to click on match to, and we're going to click first part of number. And we'll click the apply button. That will go ahead and show us all the different phone numbers that have a 321 area code to start. And when we are ready, we will just find one that we like, click on it, and select the proceed to buy section right here. Okay. So once we have purchased the phone number and we've linked the phone number into the system, you can go ahead and click on the triple dot section right here. Click edit configuration. And here's where we can start turning on or start editing the different settings of the phone system. Now, if you want the caller, if you want to be called each time somebody calls you and you want those calls to be forwarded directly to your direct line or your cell phone, you would enter the forward calls to here. So in this case, if I was entering a phone number, I would go ahead and enter in that phone number that I want the calls to be forwarded to right here. Okay. If you want those calls to be passed along, so each time somebody calls you from the CRM, you would select this checkbox right here. Now, personally, I don't like doing this. I don't like forwarding calls directly to my cell phone number. I want to be able to answer them directly within the GoHighLevel app. So what I typically do is whenever I buy a phone number, I navigate to the My Staff section right here. And I'll go ahead and select Brian, because that's who I am setting up the phone system for. And you'll see right here, I have this call and voicemail settings system right here. Go ahead and click on that. And you will see that there is a section that says inbound phone number. Now, if this is a direct line for an individual, like this is for this person here, we can go ahead and select the default inbound number, and this now becomes this person's direct line. Okay. So again, this is only required if the user needs a dedicated number, not required for voicemail or call routing to the assigned user. Okay. Now, how I personally have my section set up or my setting set up is the web app and the mobile app, and I uncheck my phone number because I want to answer that call directly within the app. What happens is when somebody calls, this populates right here on my desktop app where I can answer the desktop phone, or excuse me, I can answer that incoming call directly from my computer. If I'm on the go, I can also answer it directly inside of the GoHighLevel app, and this allows for me to be able to differentiate what type of phone call I'm getting. So if they're not being forwarded to my number, I'm able to see, okay, this is a contact from my CRM calling me. I'm able to answer that directly in the phone app settings and the mobile app settings as well. Okay. Now, I typically like to have timeout settings at 20 seconds. I've ended up lowering this to 10 seconds because if I'm not responding in 10 seconds, voice AI will pick up, and I'll show you guys how to enable that in another video. But ultimately, this is now saved inside of the system. Okay. Now I'm going to navigate back to phone numbers here because there's one other thing that we need to do if we want to turn off the call forwarding feature, and that is navigate to advanced settings. Okay. So you'll see that I have this set up as an LC phone system. on this voice calls section right here, there is a setting underneath the inbound call section that forwards calls to business number. So if activated, calls will be forwarded to the business phone in case the forwarding number and assigned phone numbers user is not configured. We do not want this based on how we just set up the settings. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to toggle this off. And in addition to that, I'm also going to toggle this off. And the reason being is because if I have a team that is working using the phone system and each of them has their own dedicated line, the assigned user would be the one who's called every single time that that client calls them versus the phone number that they're actually calling. So please make sure that you navigate into the advanced settings, voice call, and turn off the inbound call features right here. Okay. Now, this changed recently, so you'll see the voicemail missed call text back. So if we want to enable this section right here, we need to navigate right here. This will bring the incoming call timeout to 10 seconds. We can upload a call, and then our missed call text back is now located right here. Now you'll see right here, it defaults to the location name, okay? If we wanted to customize this to say, hey, this is Jonathan. I saw I missed your call. How can I help you? I would click customize. I can navigate right here and change the location name. Let's just say I want this to be, I'll do username. So whoever the assigned user is. Okay. Click on that button right there. And now that system is all set up. Okay. Now, we also have this SMS compliance section, okay? And you'll notice right here, this is where we can customize our unsubscribe or out message. I'll typically leave reply stop to unsubscribe, or I'll change it maybe to reply out to unsubscribe. You just need to make sure that you have an automation in place that will remove this section. And then each very first text message that goes out, this references the location ID right here. So the very first text that goes out, if we wanted to customize this to say Jonathan, we would change the sender ID right here. And that will go ahead and change this to say, thanks, Jonathan. Okay, so please make sure that you check the phone settings, especially with the new features that are enabled. Now, they used to have it where you could update the limit. Looks like that turned that back off again. You have to unlock level 2, unlock level 3, or you can reach out to high level support and they will increase your messaging limit. And then my absolute favorite feature, especially because I used to have a call center, is the call script section. You can now add and create your call scripts directly inside of the system. So it's super simple to add those call scripts. When you're making an outbound call, what ends up happening is do you want to use a call script action populates, and then you can have your full-blown script ready to rock right here. So again, High Level's doing some awesome stuff with the phone systems. Highly recommend you check this out and change your voicemail settings so that way you guys are ready to rock. Okay, appreciate you guys. Hope you have a great rest of your day, and I will chat with you guys a little bit later.